If you have tens of thousands of things to control, you need tens of thousands at least of buttons, if not knobs to turn. 10,000 is 100 times 100. And you begin to get a very large and confusing panel of buttons. You need a system in which you zoom in on the problem you're currently solving and temporarily obscure everything else.
Frank Beck and technician Ben Stumpy come up with a solution. They call it the touchscreen. The idea has been tried before, but not like this, with multi-use buttons activated by the electric charge within a human finger.
One of the very first things a child can do is to point. So it's a very natural sort of thing to point at the thing you want and to get the answer immediately. If you could have a central button system, which is the touchscreen, then the man could be sitting there, and just by pointing to a device, he could address any equipment in the machine.
They etch tiny wires onto the back of their screen, wires that detect a human touch. It's an idea that's still in use in modern smartphones.
One electrode, if you like, is the pair of wires printed on a screen, and the other one is your finger. You bring a finger up to it and to complete the capacitive circuit.
By 1976, the impressively named synchrotron was finally ready to go on stream, controlled by the power of human touch.
When the thing was finally working, I came and looked at it, and I touched the thing. And it was, I can't describe to you how exciting it was. It's like writing a poem and suddenly hearing it recited by somebody. It was absolutely wonderful. I didn't realize that there would be a million of them. I didn't realize that I would own one in my motor car and another one in my pocket. But I did realize that we got onto something great.